Hi everybody, happy Sunday, happy self-care Sunday. I'm actually going to just give myself a face mask and I wanted to jump on here because I wanted to talk about the importance of taking care of yourself, especially when you are, you know, you tend to struggle with being pulled in so many directions throughout the week and you're trying to recharge and reset and then you're trying to play catch up on the weekend. So all I can say is if you have about 10, 15, 20 minutes for yourself today, go do the things. And even if you can, like I'm about to spend an hour, I'm going to do this face mask and talk a little bit about it with you guys. And while I'm letting my face mask sit, I'm going to go in and throw like a bunch of stuff in the washer that will set me up for success this coming week. So I don't have to worry about all of that. Just having all, you know, the proper sweatpants and shirts put together for the week, you know, the use for staying at home. But I'm also going to wash my hair. And if anyone here, please raise your hand if anyone feels this, but I actually wash my hair about every seven. It's seeming like on Sundays or Mondays are my best time to wash my hair. So 7-8 days, sometimes if I'm lucky, I make it to like day 9 or 10 and even 12. But for the most part, I feel like that's a really good happy medium. I find when I start putting it up in a bun like this, it's time to wash. You know what I'm saying? But I also take like showers every single day, but just to like rinse my body, wash my face, do all the things. But I'm going to actually do a quick face mask right now. So if you guys have never used skin polish, I'm telling you right now, this is actually the best face mask I've ever used. I used to use some really questionable stuff out there. Those things that were messing with my hormones, messing with my overall, skin issues that I was having. I actually am acne prone, so I was really struggling with, you know, putting stuff on there that wasn't helping. It was actually hurting and like not helping my skin. So this actually has jojoba beads in it. It smells like lemon, okay? The jojoba beads actually are going to break down in the ecosystem, so it is friendly. It's like eco-friendly for the fish, so they're not going to be swallowing it and getting full and all, you know, hurting them, which I love that about these products. They are vegan. They're free of those harmful chemicals. So they are going to really just be so good. So guys, I've been really on this journey of making sure that I'm putting the proper stuff on my body, on my skin, things like that, in my body, things I eat and drink, right? Because that is going to affect my hormone production. So if anyone's struggling out there, like I am, especially with getting pregnant, just like on this bit of a road, like this journey to motherhood, for a while now has taught me a little bit about that extra self-care that you need to do. You absolutely need to do. I'm actually going to let this get up into my hairline a little bit because I'm about to wash my hair. So I'm going to be okay with that kind of getting up there because I really like to make sure I exfoliate right along here. But if you guys struggle with acne-prone skin or any dry skin, this face mask in particular is for everybody, okay? So I'm actually going to go in and scrub my hands too because the main thing that we need to remember when we're taking care of our skin is hydration and exfoliation. So hydration is going to really help just restore that. The exfoliation is going to take all those dead skin cells away and just give you basically kind of like that new layer of skin that we need and want. Kind of something fresh to work with. And I notice if I'm struggling with my skin a little bit, I always go back to this face mask because it could be that my makeup's not laying properly or my overall skin tone does not look as nice as it was looking because of those dead skin cells on top. Especially with the cold weather, our skin is meant to kind of like tighten up and get dry, right? But also it does that too to help protect the inner layer of skin. So your skin actually is a pretty amazing thing. It's going to be doing a lot of protecting for you. So when you when you're not taking care of it, then it's actually going to struggle that much more. So I love to go in with this lemon face mask, and it's actually slightly with lemons in it, but lemon, they're cold pressed lemons. They also have, I'm actually going to read it to you guys because I'm telling you, this face mask has been a game changer for my skin. Our nutrient-rich mask soothes, hydrates, and gently exfoliates away dry skin. With extracts from lemon and cypress, it keeps moisture in the skin while the natural jojoba beads roll away impurities. Love that. So you can actually keep this on for about 10 to 15 minutes. I scrub my face, as you can see, for a couple minutes, and that just gives it a really nice, good scrub. And before I take it off, I scrub it again a little bit with some water and then rinse away. So I'm actually going to finish doing that. So if you're interested, I'm just going to tell you, you can buy if you're struggling with like acne prone skin, I highly recommend this, or you might need a spot treat with Mask of Zen, which is made of tea tree oil and clay. This actually is going to help for normal to oily skin. This is going to be for all skin types. So I kind of feel like if you, like everybody needs skin polish in their life. But let me know in the comments, like what face masks are you using? What do you find works best for your skin? I kind of feel like less is more when I over, when I'm like putting too much stuff on my skin all the time. I find that my skin is just like on kind of overdrive. It's like, what are you giving me? What are you doing right now? So this is just really great. I kind of keep it really simple. So you can buy these separately, or you can actually buy them in a skin confidence collection. You'll get one cleanser, one moisturizer, and one face mask. I highly recommend doing that. I always start at that, depending on your budget, or maybe you're just like, you know what, I just need that exfoliation and hydration. Because guys, what's really cool about this face mask, it's actually going to help help you produce, it's going to generate new skin cell growth. And that's what you want for that fresh, youthful looking skin, is the regeneration of skin cell growth. So taking off a bit of that layer that's there, that's just sitting there and like causing backup, causing you to have like not the best overall skin tone. And then when you go to put your makeup on, you might even be struggling that your makeup isn't laying properly because of that exfoliation and hydration is not there. So I'm a big fan of exfoliating, a big fan of obviously moisturizing. I use a ton of other products too. I don't say ton, but like a handful of other products to make sure that that moisture is always there. But if you're also experiencing, are you, Ryan, that's awesome. I was just actually talking about that. It's such a good thing to have. But if you're also experiencing any like issues like maskne, I got to tell you, I don't break out. I think it's a rare thing when I jump on here and I talk about a breakout. I got like one little pimple and then there was another one that evolved there. And I'm telling you, because of these products, it used to sit there for the longest time. This is only like day 3 and it's basically healed. All that stuff came to the surface. I didn't have to like do anything and pick at it or whatever. I just used my products in there. Mask of Zen is really great for pulling if you do have any maskne issues that's happening or clogged pores. Maybe you're having blackheads on your nose. Mask of Zen is a really great spot treatment for that. So you can really go in and cover your nose, cover the areas that have that and let it sit on there for a while. I've even been known to go to sleep with the Mask of Zen and let it pull stuff clay is going to help really pull things to the surface. Tea tree oil is going to help treat the bacteria and any, it's going to be antibacterial. So just really pulling the stuff to the surface and giving you that overall like really healthy glow that you want in your skin. So I highly recommend taking a little bit of self-care. Like I said, I'm about to go wash my hair, do all the things. Then I usually then style my hair. And so, you know, just give my hair that extra treatment that it deserves, especially because I'm on camera so much. And so just giving myself that little bit of extra glow, extra thing that I need to kind of get me through the day. So if you have any questions about that, please let me know. Like I said, you can do a cleanser, a moisturizer, and a face mask, or just do a cleanser and moisturizer to start out with and then add in the face mask, or just get the face mask on its own. I love that there's two and it's just so like, for me, very easily treatable. So that's how I kind of look at, I really love to look at my, my face masks as how am I treating this? So, you know, if I'm struggling, like I said, with the extra dead skin cells, I know I'm going to go in and do, sometimes I'll even double up on my masks. I'll go in and do this, keep this on for a few minutes, scrub my face with it, let the hydration kind of soak in there, rinse it off. And then I'll sometimes then go in with the clay mask and just let some of the stuff pull to the surface for a little while. If I'm experiencing blackheads or have a breakout anywhere, especially in the maskne area. Guys, just to remind you too, when you're wearing a mask, what's happening is it's causing a bit of friction on your face and causing little micro tears. So if you're overhydrated, and this is where it can get confusing, if you're overhydrated with your mask on, meaning you put on a really heavy lotion and then you went out for the day, you might actually find that when you get home, you have like little marks or like little, you'll create little micro tears. You won't even be able to see them, but actually your mask area is a breeding ground for bacteria. And so then over time, then the next few days, you might have been like, oh man, my face is so dry, and you do all this. And then you might notice over time, you start getting clogged pores around that area. So what you're gonna wanna do is exfoliate and hydrate at night, full on exfoliation and hydration, mega hydration at night. Then in the morning, when you wash your face and you do everything, you're gonna wanna hydrate a small amount. You did the bulk of your hydration overnight, you slept with it on, and then you're gonna find a moisturizer that is a little bit lighter, that can withstand that if you sweat a little bit, it's not gonna cause like a lot of friction. The other thing is keeping a barrier between your mask and your skin. So that might be even wearing just like a little bit of makeup. I know that kind of sounds a little counterproductive, but personally, I love to use the Lime Lice foundation because it does not clog my pores. It's not going to settle in, and it kind of just creates that bit of a barrier between my skin, the foundation, and the mask. So if you have questions, please reach out and ask me or mask me. I know a lot about it because I've done a lot of studying up on it, and I've actually really, really helped my skin to heal. Not just outwardly, but very inwardly too, on other things that I've been doing in order to do that. I have the best skin of my life, and when I get a pimple, that happens here and there, but it used to be where I would get one and my whole face would get loaded with them, and you know, it took away from a lot of like the hard work that I was doing. Made me feel a certain way, and so I truly understand what that is. Even though I don't experience it much anymore, I know what you're going through. If you have dry skin and aged skin and you're struggling with that, like you can't get your makeup to sit properly, or you don't feel as confident in your skin, please reach out to me. I can totally help you find certain products that are going to amplify and help those and treat those areas that you might be struggling with. So with that said, I'm going to go finish up my self-care Sunday. I'm going to drop those clothes in the wash and just get myself all together and set myself up for success for the week. So please make sure you take care of yourself. Take care of someone else. And if you have questions, please reach out to me. Happy Sunday, everybody, and have a beautiful and blessed day. Bye, everyone.